So today I thought I'd show a quick little tutorial about using Mineways and just show some of the features that you can do to clean up your model and get it ready to print. So I thought I'd try making our community station here. And some of the interesting features of the community station are it's got this big glass roof, which is sort of nice in theory, but if you print it in, 3D printing material right now, it's not transparent. So I'll talk about how to remove the roof. And there's some other interesting elements, like in real life, this thing is just floating in space and is not going to be able to really print out that way. We haven't invented anti-gravity for the printers yet, so that's going to be a problem. So, well, let's get to it. So I'm going to start up Mineways, and let's get rid of that. So I'll load this model, and this is where the station is. So I'm using a mouse wheel to zoom in, and then I pick about the location that looks like the station. And I can tune this up later. In fact, I think I'll kind of mess it up just so that I can show you how tune-up works. The other thing I should note here is the way to set depth. You're basically picking out an area that you're trying to, print out, but you also need to set depth. The way I personally prefer is to use the bracket keys, the braces keys. So if I go up, you'll see less and less is getting selected as I go up using the basically the left brace, and by going down using the right brace. The other thing you can do is just press on a place. So what I'm going to do is press. I know that it's kind of deep in this area where there's some water. So by just middle mouse pressing there, I've established a depth. It basically will say, okay, I'm going to go that deep when I export. So let's just try exporting at this point. So I've exported and I get this warning. And what that warning is telling you is that there are indeed floating parts. There are pieces that are just kind of floating in space, and we saw what those pieces are, but or I showed them to you in advance. But one thing that you can do is to see where those pieces are floating is to use this debug option, show separate parts as colors. So with that in place, now I've exported the file. Here's the file, and I double-click it. I've hooked up the SAP Viewer Complete to show this file, so it'll come up in a second. Dum-de-dee-da-dum. And there we go. So what this is showing us is basically where there are big chunks floating in space. So there was that one big chunk in the middle of the place. There's also this other chunk here. And so both of those chunks I'm fine with getting rid of and not having around. So let's get rid of that and try to export again. So the way to get rid of those chunks is to pick my place again, get rid of the debug because now we know what's going on, and crank this up to 1,000 or whatever. It doesn't matter how high you crank this actually. It'll always try to, well, it does matter, but it'll always keep the largest part it finds in the scene. So if you don't mind losing all the little bits, just kick this number as high as you want. So now I've exported again. I can go and look at that again, and let's see. So I bring this up. Notice there's a reload file thing there. And that's starting to look pretty good. I've noticed though that, oh gee, I cut away, a part of my station, which actually is a thing I kind of like to do. In this case, I'm going to show you how you remove the glass top, but this is sort of a cool way to actually be able to see the insides of some of your buildings. But okay, so let's adjust that. And the way I do that is just simply come in. I can now right-click on an edge and pull it out until I feel like, yeah, I think I've got, what I need there. And let's see, so I could look at this thing, look around, see what else is, what else is defective or looks okay or whatever. This is looking somewhat reasonable. These trees are not maybe the best thing in the world, but might be okay. So anyway, let's go on from there. Okay, this back wall, I'm seeing some of the water wall here. looking at the bottom. The bottom looks like the bottom floor is kind of getting wiped out. So what I can do is things like I'm going to lower the depth to see if I can capture more of the floor. And what I've done is just, again, sort of use the braces key, the bracket key, and I've lowered the bottom depth there. So if I kick it down another notch, you see it goes down to 60. Let's see. So anyway, that's probably pretty good. Let's kick this out a bit, maybe, you know, capture some of those trees. And let's try again. Okay, so assuming this works well, and even if it doesn't, I'll move on to the next thing. Okay, that didn't work so great. Like, now I've got this sort of big, long piece here that is going to not print very well. It's way too thin to really support this whole chunk here. So let's pull the wall in a little bit so that lava feature just won't get printed out. And let's see, let's just look underneath. Okay, looks like I got the floor now, if that's what I want. Let's see. Oh, I should mention one other feature here. So this looks somewhat reasonable. Is when I export, if you turn on this thing called Fill in Isolated Tunnels, basically what it'll do is try to essentially any of these tunnels that are kind of going to nowhere that don't attach to the outside world, they'll get closed off. And that has two advantages. One is that you might just not want the holes in your model, although it looks kind of cool. The other thing, though, the sort of important thing from just a cost standpoint, so you can see some of these tunnels got sealed off. These glass blobs here are where the tunnels that didn't reach the outside world, they got kind of sealed off. And the advantage there is just that when you seal these things off, it tends to have this effect of allowing more of the bottom to get hollowed out. Anyway, so that's where we are with this. This model's looking, you know, somewhat reasonable for export. But like I say, you got this big glass top you're not going to be able to see in. So how do we get rid of that? Pretty straightforward. What you can do is, I've already set up some schemes, but I'll set up a new scheme. So I've added a scheme. This is color scheme 1. And what you can do in color schemes is, let's just call this no glass. And what you can do is basically go and edit materials as you wish. So this one is the glass block. This is the color of the glass block. It's in this hexadecimal form. I talk on the web page how to get this hexadecimal form. It's pretty common for web pages to use this kind of crazy color scheme. Alpha, what that is how opaque something is. So 255 means it's fully opaque, you can't see through it. 0 means it's totally invisible. And by setting something to 0, that tells Mineways that oops, I just hit the wrong button there. Don't hit that button. So we'll now go about how you remove a scheme. So let's add a scheme again. We'll go through it real quick. Anyway, what you do is by setting the alpha, you can by setting it to 0, it basically says don't export that type of block. What the hide all blocks thing does is, by the way, is you can hide all blocks. It'll set all the alphas to 0. Then you can go and pick out a block that you particularly want to export. So for example, if I was really getting fancy here, I could have a separate color scheme. So this is my no glass, and watch what happens when I go to the view. It's pulled the glass out, basically. So let's export here. And let's see, yeah, it's fine. And so what we should see here is no glass on the roof. Anyway, what I was going to say is that, and I'm tempted to do that for this model, is that I could also go into here and make a whole separate system, basically a whole separate pass where I just export just the glass object. And that's where this hide and, you know, hide everything becomes useful. Like, because I could hide all the blocks, and then I would turn the glass blocks on, and then by doing that, I could see just the glass piece, and I could print that out separately. So then I could sort of glue the glass top onto the onto this place. So anyway, that's about it. I just wanted to show some of those features that you can go in and edit to your heart's content, change size, play around with stuff. So that's I think that's all the features that I want to show for today, and I hope it helps you out. And give it a try. It's really not, it's pretty easy to do this stuff. I think people get daunted by, oh, it's 3D, and oh, it's 3D printing. I don't know what I'm doing. For the most part, most of these models will print just fine with the default settings. Knowing a little bit about how the program works, like knowing about, setting the sealing the tunnels and stuff like that, just means you'll print a little less material and save yourself a little money. And that's about all. Thanks. Bye.